Let's talk about Mortal Engines, directed by Christian Rivers, written by Fran Walsh, Philippa Boyens, Peter Jackson, and Philip Reeve. Cast is Hera Hilmar, Robert Sheehan, Hugo Weaving, and Ji-Ha. I don't know how to say that name, but that's close enough. So this is my swift shot. Mortal Engines is a movie about giant traction cities that go around devouring other cities that fall into their path based on the pretense of something called municipal Darwinism. Essentially, the film delivers a heavy metaphor for anti-colonialism and the responsibility of citizens to keep their behemoth expansionist nations in check. It was a fun film that sucked me in with interesting characters and plenty of action. Sadly, it lacked much in the way of steampunk, which I thought would be the main draw for audiences. But there are plenty of homages to Star Wars, and it had this strange Watership Down vibe that I definitely appreciated. The movie starts out with a fantastic chase through the Great Hunting Ground, where London, now basically a transforming tracked battleship, or maybe battleburg, is hunting a smaller city. Immediately, we are shown how Londoners react to being part of the chase and how exuberantly gleeful they are to devour this pathetic remnant of Europe that has the misfortune of being their next acquisition. One almost gets a sense that they are cheering about soccer rather than the subjugation of an entire town. On the soon-to-be-devoured city is a masked woman, Hester Shaw, played by Hilmar, who has designs on getting aboard London and doing some dark business, the business of vengeance. But as all this is happening, this action-packed pursuit, we are introduced to a dorky historian, Tom Natsworthy, played by Sheehan, who is rushing to get to his rather pedestrian job at the London Museum. He's annoyed that London has to constantly run down these smaller anti-tractionist cities that simply refuse to assimilate to London. Come to think about it, maybe there are more similarities to Star Trek rather than Star Wars. I mean, London is basically a Borg cube. Anyway, as with all great ships, there needs to be a great leader at the helm. London is steered by the charismatic Thaddeus Valentine, played by Weaving, who is also annoyed with anti-traction cities, but he also recognizes that the Great Hunting Ground isn't quite so great anymore. It's essentially costing more fuel to pursue and consume their prey than the resources they bring in upon assimilation. In other words, this municipal Darwinism shit isn't working anymore. They're running out of resources to acquire. Meanwhile, Tom is always getting into trouble for being late to work, so as punishment, he has been assigned to guard duty. But it's not what you're thinking. He's been sent down to rifle through all the stuff that's been stolen from the newly acquired citizens of London and to guard the historically significant artifacts, relics from the past, from being tossed into the fire. The fire that fuels London. This assignment changes his life and ultimately reshapes mankind, all because he crosses paths with Hester Shaw and his mind is open to the possibility he's not on the right side of history. But that's getting a bit ahead of the story, as the two are both unceremoniously ousted off of London in a pretty revealing scene about who can and can't be trusted. They're forced to work together to survive the sprawling, desolate wastelands of Europe. All that really remains are the giant tread marks left by the crawling cities. Tom and Hester start off as enemies, so their relationship isn't cozy at the beginning, but as it becomes clearer by the moment that Tom is actually a hazard to keep around, Hester's motivation for not ditching him is not so much out of necessity as it is something foreign to her. Sentiment. See, Hester has had a terrible life. She is scarred from an encounter with her mother's killer when she was just a child. How she survived that is nothing short of miraculous, but her survival skills help her and Tom survive. Tom just wants to get back home, to London, and Hester wants to carry out her vengeance. Fate intervenes to shift their gears to a new goal, basically saving millions of lives. There's a lot of character in Mortal Engines, and I was initially irked that we didn't get to see giant battles between two roving kingdoms as I was expecting from the trailers. Still, what made me enjoy this film was the introduction of a character that I have to be careful not to spoil here, but he was played in motion capture by Stephen Lang, a resurrected man called Shrike. And when you first meet him, you'll see why I think Shrike makes the movie much better. His agenda isn't quite what you're initially led to believe from a certain point of view. As the Maroon duo try to survive the wastelands, they're eventually saved by Anna Feng, Ji-Ha, the leader of the Anti-Traction League. She's as much a badass as you'd expect her to be as the leader of a resistance force that has a huge bounty on her head. And as she saves Hester and Tom, she helps Hester understand her purpose. Her mission is to stop Valentine, the man she wants to kill. So really, it's a win-win for her, and since Tom was booted from London by the jerk, yeah, he's on board for a little payback too. So the film culminates in a somewhat one-sided battle as London unleashes a terrible weapon from the past. This quantum weapon called Medusa is what led to the destruction of much of the world's population and cities. It's bad news, and only a lunatic who doesn't understand its power would be foolish enough to use it. Sacrifices are necessary to win the day, and allegiances and relationships shift at the end to reveal a new dawn for mankind. Based on the Philip Reeve young adult series of the same name, this film delivers heavy on the action and will entertain you. At the end of my screening, someone shouted out in the audience, "Well, that sucked," and I wondered what they were on about. When Hollywood does something original, I applaud them for taking risks. The movie definitely didn't suck. The effects were pretty decent, given that they were, were to believe that these cities can transform as people are walking all over them. And there were some obvious homages to The Empire Strikes Back, and there was a message about human nature and that love can exist in the most desolate of hearts. Maybe that guy who shouted out that the film sucked has never actually had the pleasure of working on a film, because while this movie was far from perfect, it was engaging and thought-provoking. I'm sure he thought Batman vs. Superman was compelling cinematic gold. Whatever. My advice, Mortal Engines is fun. I'd definitely check it out in theaters because there's a lot of really big action sequences and solid special effects.